Hi, if you haven't just heard about the new global sets in the Zoho CRM and you don't know how it works, this video is for you. My name is Alex Weiss. I'm going to show you how the new global sets in the Zoho CRM, also called global picklist, works. First, let's go to the location where you can see this new feature. As you log into your CRM, go to the top right here to set up. In the setup under customization, click in modules and fields. In modules and fields, you will see this new tab here called global sets. Click on that. For as beginning as default, Zoho added these two new global sets, the industry and source. As you probably know, Zoho will give you these two fields for accounts and leads as a default with a pre-populated list. Zoho did the same here, add the same list here. I'm going to show you how it works to bring this list to all the modules that you'd like to have this industry as well. Right now you can see this section here, this column called used in, doesn't have any module. As we go through, you're gonna see it's gonna populate this section here. Let's click on setup here. I'm gonna open another tab. Click again in modules and fields. Now let's click in accounts. Click standard. You can see the field here, industry. Let's click in the ellipsis. Click edit properties. It's the same list as you saw in the global set here. It's the same list, but it's not connect. As you can see this new section here at the top, it's local. It means you could go and add a new option here and wouldn't be connected to the global set. What we are going to do right now, we are going to connect this field to the global set so we can edit this field from the global set. Click global set, selecting the industry. You see the same list. Because it's exactly the same list, it map it. If it had a different option, which I'm gonna show you later, it would show you the option how you would like to kind of connect them. Let's click done and save. Let's go back here. It's also in leads. Let's click standard. You have the industry here, ellipsis, edit properties, the same list. Let's click global set and choose industry and done. Let's click save. Let's go back. It doesn't go normally. It doesn't come as defaults to the contacts. Let's add to the contacts so you can see how it can be added. Let's bring a picklist here. Let's put that at the top. Industry. You see, could it be local, but let's use the global sets, industry grant. It pre-populates and click done and save. Now let's go back to the global sets. Let's click industry and let's add new option. Let's move to the top and save. Now let's go and open a new tab with the lead. Click in the lead. You have the industry here. You can see new option here. Let's go to contacts. Click one of the contacts. Industry, new option here. The same with accounts. New option here. It means in the past, you need to go to every single module and add the new option. Right now, you can just add to one location and add to all the fields. Let's go back and create a new one. Testing global set option 1, 2, and three. Let's click save. And let's go back to the module. Let's go to contact. You would bring the pick list. Let's click global set. Actually, let's don't save this one. Cancel here. Let's refresh this page so we can see the option. Let's go to contacts. You bring the pick list here. Global set. You have a testing global set. You see everything comes over here. Let's click done and save. Let's say for any reason you want to go and bring the, if we go to here to accounts, we have account type, edit, properties. You have this list here and you want to make this a global set. But if you go here, you don't have this as an option. Let's cancel here. What I did pretty much, let's go click again here. I copy already, you know, this list. It's on my side here. And let's go to the setup. Create global set. Let's call type, copying the list here. Let's add as bulk. Let's delete this option one and option two. Actually, let's add option test here at the top, which is different from the type. And I'm going to show you what's going to happen when it's not exactly the same list. Let's click save. You see, those are already associated here. This one associated with contacts. Type is not associated yet. Let's go to accounts. Let's refresh. Now let's click again here, ellipsis, edit properties. Let's change the global set. Now we have type here. And we click done and save. You see, I made one field that was not global set. I made it a global set by bringing the data, creating the field, and adding the same list. This is a tool that is very helpful. It would be before you would need to go and copy all the data from one location to another. It's something even if you're in like a large team and people is adding options to those fields, it can be very messy. Even like sometimes putting like by mistake, the name, like writing like misspelling, it can be an issue. Now if this global set, you can edit all the fields between all the modules in one location.
If you found this video helpful, be sure to like it and leave us a comment. You can also subscribe to our channel and click the bell next to the subscribe button to be notified of new videos. If you want to learn more about Zoho or would like help with anything Zoho related, head on over to our website at zcrmhelp.com to connect with us. Thanks for watching.